welcome to Renee and Irish Greg's pop-up show. Yay. We are so lucky to have you with us here at the Haight Street Art Center in beautiful San Francisco.
Yes, and welcome to the Stanley Mouse exhibit at the Haight Street Art Center. Isn't this, by applause, just say how much you enjoy it for everybody.
One thing I love about the Haight Street Art Center is the way they do each show. It's usually very clean, very simplistic. You can see everything really beautifully laid out. And the exhibit this time, what was different for me, the way they painted the walls really looks fantastic with the paintings and the art and the posters this time. So I feel like they did an exceptional
job.
So
what you may not know, and this is true of art galleries all over the world, and I sound like I'm an expert and I don't have a clue, but I'm here enough to know that every time an exhibit comes down, this entire building gets repainted. Can you imagine repainting the interior of your house every time? And they redo it. And this exhibit opened last Saturday, and 2 days before that, it was mayhem. Stanley Mouse literally wanted every piece of art he's ever done to be in this exhibit, and you've got to pare it down.
Wow.
So, but they got it done, and it's amazing. So please, the other thing is, the Haight Street Art Center is a nonprofit, and it is free to the public. So it's an amazing, amazing resource. And they, you know, they don't have a whole lot of money to advertise. So, although they do use your Blue Bear School of Music bus backs.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We have a partnership with them.
Yeah, they do have them. But please tell your friends, because this is just awesome. Yeah. And it's free. It's open Wednesday through Sunday at noon till 6 p.m. every day. So, the wonderful Haight Street Art Center. Another round of applause for the Haight Street Art Center. Okay, so you're here for the Stanley Mouse exhibit, but you're mostly here. You're not here to hear us yak away, right? So, Renee, why don't you bring up our
please welcome
guest, an old friend,
a dear friend, Greg Loiacono. Did I say it right?
So you'll notice tonight. One thing you will notice is that I will never say Greg. Last name.
No, he just says it first.
Because I go Greg, and then I go, I can't say your fucking last name.
Renee, that was exquisite.
Greg,
really?
Better than some family members.
Greg, Greg Loiacono.
I think
I can do it.
You can do it.
Because I'm all Luciano and all this. Greg Loiacono.
Yeah.
Okay.
Very well done.
Hi, Greg.
I feel bad because
nice
we've known Greg for God. We've known Greg probably for 20 years.
Getting close
so I
to
should
it.
I should know your.
Well, you know, Greg and I were talking about this earlier. That Greg came on the KFUG morning show. The Mother Hips came on the show when Greg had your son was just born.
I think he was just tiny then. Yeah.
And he's 18 now.
Yes. So yes. There we go.
So that's a trip, man.
We know.
Now having kids, that's the only way I can tell like time is going
so
by.
So Tim and Greg were great, great friends of the KFUG Morning Show, and we're glad that we've continued this friendship.
Absolutely.
What was the record you made? The Green Hill?
Green Hills of Earth.
The Green Hills of Earth is still that. I play that a lot. That is a great record.
Yeah,
do you ever go back to that?
Oh, yeah. Yeah. We, I think not too long ago, we did the whole record.
Oh, really? It's so good. Know, what was that? Like the early 2000s?
It came out in 2000, I think. Yeah.
Okay, good record.
Yeah.
Anyway, we're going to talk to Greg about what he's got going on. We were just talking beforehand. It seems social media amplifies things, and it makes it feel like Greg is playing every night of the year.
I know.
Yeah. And he's like, you're gone all the time. I'm like,
not really.
A little bit.
But Greg, he's a busy man, so we'll talk to him about everything that's going on. But let's get a tune from Greg Loiacono.
Yes. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Greg.
Thank you. I'm the real hero tonight.
You got it? All right, I'm going to do a song that's a fairly new song. It's called Chamberlain's Trunk. Oh, so we're going to do that.
I like this. I just
I came by your room, but your door was locked. Nobody answered after 24 knocks. I kicked down some doors back in my day, but something told me I should walk away. Yeah, the last time I saw you was stumbling drunk. You left your guitar in Chamberlain's trunk. I felt my hand reach out as you started to sway, but something told me I shouldn't stay. And I won't care until you want me to. I saw you skirting out on that ledge. You like it uncomfortably close to the edge. If you fell into the ocean, would you finally be free to heed the whines of the sirens' plea? And I won't care until you want me to. I'll be there when you want me to. It's something when you need it. It's nothing when you're not. Trying to find the difference always has me lost. Did you do it on purpose? Did you try to make it hurt? You started on grass, ended up in the dirt. Hey, nothing these days comes as much surprise, not love or hate or truth or lies. Hey, nothing these days carries much surprise, so I'm gonna walk away cause I see it in your eyes.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Beautiful.
Thanks.
That is new music from Greg Loiacono.
Wonderful. You released that about, what, 6 months ago?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
September, October.
It's a couple of things about it. It's got a really nice video. Your videos are really good.
Yes,
so who does, if you follow Greg, certainly on Facebook, which is where, because I'm old, that's where I find most of his stuff. Who does your...
Darren Ney. Do you know Darren
Ney? No, I don't.
Darren Ney is a fantastic artist all around. He's a guitar player and video maker and songwriter. Played with Nikki Bloom and the Gramblers.
Okay.
And plays with a bunch of other people. And so he made the video for Chamberlain's Trunk and for the two other singles that were released in 2019. Of mine.
And they're all really, really good.
Yeah.
I had what grabbed me most, the song is beautiful. I love the name. What?
Chamberlain's Trunk?
Yeah.
That's pretty funny.
He's like, and then he doesn't talk about it.
It's a long and complicated story, but it's an inside joke, that name, with my family.
Oh, okay.
Just because.
Because I was thinking, like, Neville Chamberlain, who was, like, Prime Minister of...
It sounds really good to sing.
It does. It's a wonderful name.
And it's not like Scott's trunk.
Yeah. No, it's
Leroy's trunk. Yeah, you know, it's got a nice sound to it.
Exactly.
I want to ask you about making music today. We were talking about Facebook and social media and releasing things today. Is it better, worse? Totally different, I'm sure.
It's totally different. One of the things I like, especially this go around, is that putting out these singles that I've been at. So my fourth single came out yesterday. It's called Animal Clouds. I'll try to play it. It's a more of a full band song, but I think I'll give it a whirl on the acoustic guitar. But it's fun to have, you know, this build up to a record. Whereas when you put out I love putting out a record, and I still make my music in that fashion where I'm thinking of it as a whole album. But it's been, I was a little resistant to it at first, but it's really great to put stuff out and have this sort of lead up to the album. And those four songs will be on the album. There's another seven tracks that are, that'll be on the record as well. So
I always ask this of people who, because it seems like this is more and more the norm, certainly with the guests that we have on this show. They do solo stuff, they're in bands, they do this, that, the other. Obviously, the Mother Hips is kind of your, that was your first thing. Is the Mother Hips your main thing?
Yeah.
Still?
Oh, yeah.
Like,
yeah,
when you think of Greg Loiacono, it's like, I'm in the Mother Hips. That's my main.
Yeah. Role. I mean, we still play quite a lot, and we write, and we hang out together, and yeah, so it's definitely my main thing, and I enjoy doing solo stuff, and I've got a couple other projects that I'm involved in, so it keeps me busy.
When you're writing a tune, is it this is a Greg solo record, this is a Mother Hip song?
Sometimes I know very specifically that I'm gonna, that'll be my own thing, and sometimes I'll bring a song to the guys, and it'll flatline.
Yeah, that's okay. That's fine.
I'm like, I'll show them. Yeah. I'll show them.
Great. How is Tim? We haven't seen Tim in forever.
Tim's doing great.
Okay,
yeah.
Good.
Yeah, he's.
You got to put a word in his ear. Got to do one of these.
Yeah. Oh, let's do it together.
Yeah, we'll do a Mother Hip.
That'd be great. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's good.
That'd be really fun.
Okay. Well, let's get another tune. Renee, I'm going to let you say Greg's name because I can say it, but I just want to.
Greg Loiacono,
sure.
but
what?
I'm.
Oh, did we not get the guitar the last song?
Oh no, it sounded great.
Oh, okay, good.
No. There it is.
You got it now?
Yeah.
All right, another.
That part will get edited out.
Exactly.
By me.
Exactly.
Okay, how are we getting into that?
I said something stupid.
Let's get another.
No, you asked me to say his name.
Yes, there you go.
So. Another song from Greg Loiacono.
I'm going to give you another song.
Excellent.
In fact, I'll try to play Animal Clouds here.
Okay. And
just released yesterday. Really good.
Yes, and it's available on all your digital platforms at this point, and it'll be on the record and CD. So here we go. I'm up too early to put coffee in my cup, so I walk down to the water and stare up at the animal clouds. Shape shifting before my eyes, and I wish I could move that way across the morning sky and get away from all these lies. Getting so loud, reconcile with every demon I crossed or turned. Something better than they. Rabbit run away from its hunter, and serpent slouching towards its prey on the wind, in the wind. Devour itself, swirling billows reconstruct, and I'm standing at the bottom of my love among the animal clouds. Reconcile with every demon now.
darling, and so have I. On to a compost pile, and we're waiting for the cycle to wake us up again. Reconcile with every demon I crossed or turned away. Like I was something better than they. Like I was something better than they.
Animal Cloud. I love when the clouds do that.
Like, kind of dancing over there.
Yeah.
It was lovely.
I like out of the corner of my eye, just watching you guys.
Renee's you're a lyrics girl.
I do listen to the words, yes.
Yeah. Because I'm more a melody guy.
No. I like solid words. But I also like goofy lyrics, too. I'm okay with that if they're done well.
Animal Club, what was your concern about doing that without a full band?
Just because I never done
it. Oh, yeah. I see. It sounded really good.
Thanks.
Yeah.
It's actually fun.
We also had nothing to compare it to, so it sounded
really
good.
That's right.
Yeah.
Well, then you haven't listened to the single yet.
I haven't. I'm sorry.
I want to know, you recorded all of this music. I have never been there, and I know I should be. It sounds like kind of a paradise. You record a lot of this stuff in Ojai.
Yeah.
Yeah. So what's the deal with it? So I think my understanding of Ojai is it's this kind of like little hippie enclave in the Santa Barbara Mountains.
It's about right.
Yeah.
It's very artist friendly.
It seems really cool, is it?
It's very cool and very lovely place to work. And my friend Scott Hirsch and his family live there, and his studio's there. And
yeah.
So we recorded there.
Cool.
Really nice. Yeah. Beautiful.
Do you have, because you certainly play out a lot, do you have a favorite spot in the Bay Area that you like to play?
Well, playing the Fillmore is always really nice when you get a chance to do that.
That's a big one.
The Great American Music Hall with the Mother Hips.
You do all your... So what is it? You do the hip...
Yeah, there's all kinds of...
You know what I'm trying to say.
The hipsmiths.
Thank you.
Yes, and that's been going on for 130 years now.
Yeah.
And we've been...
So it's two nights right before the...
Two or three nights,
Christmas, right?
Yes, a couple weekends before, typically.
Yeah.
And we've been doing that for a long time.
And then you got the kid show at Slim's.
You got the kid show at Slim's. And we got the Hypnic in Big Sur.
Yeah, that's like a festival,
that's
right?
That's a festival, yeah. And that's...
What's the kids show like?
The kids show is it's Slim's, which you wouldn't think was a kid,
right?
You
know, no, not at
and
all.
It's kind of dark, but Santa Claus comes.
Oh,
it's fun. Yeah, it's during the day, and I don't know. You got somebody's probably
kids,
been here before.
Do you do
been
kids
there.
Songs?
No. They're all really dark, depressing songs. Yeah. It's a bummer.
Yeah.
Like, if you're listening to the words, you know.
But don't, like, you see...
Renee would be crying.
I'd be crying.
The UC Theater in Berkeley does all these shows now of bands doing albums for kids, right? Like Dark Side of the Moon for kids. And I always...
That'd be cool.
I don't know how that works to get the kids stoned. And it's like, here's the Wizard of Oz.
You're right.
Have some drugs. Listen to me. I don't know how it works at all. I don't know. Renee, rescue me. Say something.
How about another song?
Good segue.
Thank you.
Well, because we mentioned the Hypnic, the Big Sur festival that we've been doing.
We're about to Big
this
Sur,
year,
by the way.
It's at the Fernwood Camp Resort and the tavern up above.
So it's like a camping. That's cool.
It's a small, lovely festival.
Yeah.
And this song that I'll play is actually sort of about that experience.
Okay,
cool.
For the most part.
Excellent.
So it's called Close Your Eyes, We'll Be There Soon.
Right.
Also from the new record. Carry me
on a gentle coastal breeze. Up through wooded canyons, through sprawling wineries, and grapes of mirth move through us. The shade of dead on branches, we can hear the music from far away, drawing a sea. Arriving at the festival, hearing homespun psychedelic sounds. Sometimes harsh and angled, sometimes rose and glides. We felt so good I didn't need to play. Just watch and lay with you. But the band told me it was time to go on. So I did what I came to do. Out on the highway, fiery flowers zooming by, your feet up on the dashboard, said you felt like crying, but you didn't know why. Questions answered themselves with no words but melody. And I stare across my knuckles, and I sing you off to sleep.
But now I feel like I've been there.
How you feel
like
it, right?
Was like so descriptive and
that
beautiful.
That was really lovely.
It so
felt,
beautiful.
It felt like a lullaby.
Yeah, that's
it's,
the idea.
Yeah, it's yeah. Gorgeous.
Driving home after an event, you kind of have the nostalgia in your head. Yeah. You still feel that feeling of being excited, but you're sad you're going home.
Yeah. So it's all friends. Is it like a 2-day, three? Sorry, I should know more about
it's
the 3-day
festival. Yeah, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, usually the third weekend in May.
Okay. Okay, and you get all your friends.
Oh, yeah, everybody. The family comes, and everybody comes.
That's wonderful.
And it's small and contained. It's not too
that's
crazy.
That's cool. Yeah. Not too raucous.
Yeah. It's not too rock. It gets rock at night, but it gets really. Yeah. Oh yeah, you know.
Is it like camping?
Yeah.
Yeah. God, it sounds
really
good.
Pretty.
Sam, that's maybe what we're. She's not paying attention. she's flirting with Dylan Chambers as usual. Off you go. Hi, Dylan. How's it going?
Greg is signing you up for camping, just letting
you
know.
Yeah, exactly. So I will say this. Sorry to completely derail this. Sam really likes camping. I hate camping.
Oh my God, that's like me and Mike.
You'd like this though.
Really?
Yeah,
so
you'd like
I'm
this.
Not. I don't poop in the woods, and I don't. I'm not.
The one and only time
we went camping. Do you remember this, Sam? We went camping in Big Sur, and I guess we had to. You know, you park and then you walk in. And it was literally, and I was. That was back when I smoked and I didn't take care of myself at all. And we had to hike about 20 feet. And I went on like we were in the Himalayas. And it was just like, oh, I got a poop in a hole.
That's hysterical.
So
we have the same, just a quick camping stories because they're funny. Same dynamic in my, I love to go camping. And I don't know what year it was, but 90 something. A bunch of us said, yeah, we'll all go camping. And everybody dropped off and nobody ended up going except me and my one friend pair.
Yeah.
And we're like, well, we're doing this. Yeah. So we go up wherever the heck we went, in Marin somewhere. We got there, it was dark.
Yeah.
We set up our tent and we're like, oh, what'd you bring? I'm like, I brought rum. And he's like, I brought sun chips. And we're like, great. So we ate sun chips, drank rum. When we woke up in the morning, the sun was beating on that tent, and we're like, any water?
No water. Yeah,
no water.
Yeah, you don't think of anything.
And we put our tent down in poison oak.
Oh!
On the edge of a hillside. That's my camping story.
So it's not like that.
It's not like that at all.
Greg is saying it's not like that. No.
We'll take way better care of you.
So it's kind of like glamping, I guess.
It's a little glampy.
Glamping.
But you can,
okay.
It's rock and roll camping.
Very good.
Cabins.
There are cabins, yeah.
So you're doing a lot of solo stuff right now. And you do solo stuff like you're doing now, acoustic, without
but with
two
the band
buffoons
as well.
Interrupting you.
Yeah.
And then you do stuff with the Greg Loiacono band.
Yeah, I have a band, and so we just did some shows and did something in Chico and in Sacramento and Santa Cruz. And
are you guys still hometown? Well, I know you're not from, but you guys went famously. The mother hips are from Chico.
Yeah. It's still like the you know, we still take we haven't lived there in a long time, but it feels like home.
Yeah,
so it was really
That's
nice
awesome.
To go back there.
I think that your band was the band that made that gave that town the reputation
cool fashion
in Sierra Nevada.
Oh, yeah,
there you go.
That's right.
But
it's the party town. So tell us this. Every guest we have on this show either goes to UC Santa Cruz, UC Barbara, or UC Chico. Is it Chico State?
Chico State.
So basically those are the music
schools. It's like,
and they have the reputation as the party schools.
That's true.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
That's
so
true.
The two things probably... Go hand
they
in hand.
They haven't been known to go hand in hand.
Chico's a wonderful city, though.
I love it. Yeah.
A lot of fun. And you guys did a lot of benefits up there a couple of years ago when there was all the fires and all that. So, so good job with that.
Thank you.
Tell us about the other work you do. Obviously, you do the Mother Hips, and then you do the Greg Loiacono band. But,
And then there's the Greenleaf Rustlers is another band that I have. That's a fun, really fun band. That's Chris Robinson. And Barry Sless playing pedal steel guitar, and Pete Sears on bass, and either John Molo or Tony Leone on drums.
It's a killer band.
And,
That's the whole North Bay crew, right?
Yeah.
How often do you guys get to play together?
Last year we actually got quite a few gigs under our belt. I think it's going to slow down because of the
Black Crows.
So there's nothing on the... But there's a record. There's actually...
A little thing called the Black Crows has suddenly happened again.
So,
and
there's a record actually out That'll be out on March 6th or 4th or something. I didn't even really know it was coming out. But there will be it's on vinyl, and it's from some live shows. Betty Cantor recorded them.
Oh,
she's
cool.
Famous.
Cool.
She's the Grateful Dead.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so I think we'll have to check. Whatever the records come out on Friday, not Tuesdays anymore. Right.
Yes. They come out
so
on
whatever
Fridays
that Friday
now,
is, March 6th or 4th or something
Isn't
like
that funny? Isn't that so weird? Suddenly they went from Tuesday to Friday. It's like
6th.
And that must be fun because Chris has got the Chris Robinson band, and now after all these years, he's got the Black Crowes. But it sounds like that's the Greenleaf Rustlers is a way for you all to just kind of hang
really
loose
fun.
And have
we do cover songs.
Yeah.
It's mostly like country rock songs, Waylon Jennings and the Flying Burrito Brothers and New
See, that's
Riders
my wheelhouse. I got to go see you guys.
Yeah, it's really fun. And some of it's more traditional, and Barry and I are kind of doing the twin guitar stuff. And then some of it gets real out there.
Okay,
cool.
Jammy.
Cool.
So it's like jammy as well. I know. When did Chris Robinson become like a West Marin hippie?
Yeah.
we had Chris Robinson on the show here. How many of you, by applause, were at the Chris Robinson show? It was a lot of fun.
It was so great.
It was a lot of fun. I'm not telling tales out of school, I don't think, by saying this. Chris was really stoned.
No. Impossible.
But it was wonderful. So, and I'm the world's worst pot smoker. And he was like, can I go smoke somewhere? So I bring him out back out here. And he's passing this joint around. And it was a friend with him. And luckily, he didn't think to include me in the whole thing, but had he, I couldn't have, like, I would have melted on the stage. Like, I could just tell from the smell. But anyway, we go on, and he's great fun, and he talked about everything, and his management. It's so funny that the Black Crowes are now back together, because I would literally get an email from his manager every day going, you can't mention the Black Crowes, you can't mention Rich, you can't do this, you can't do that. And he talked about everything. But I found with Chris Robinson, and if you have time, go back either on our Patreon page or on our Facebook page, the interview's there, and it's hilarious, and he played tunes. But he's pretty high, and he starts telling a story. And you know what it's like when you're stoned. I don't, but you all know. when you're stoned, you start your story, and it starts rambling. And you're going, me and Renee are going, he's never going to bring this back around. This is just going to end with, what are we talking about again? But he does.
He does.
He brings it back
around.
Yeah,
he brings it
Very
back
smart.
Around.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that was a
Those
lot
are people who can handle weed.
Exactly. I'm not that person.
I'm not that person either.
I noticed downstairs, I don't know if it was Dylan Chambers or if it was just the smell of Haight Street, but this exhibit tonight has smell-o-vision. I don't know if you noticed that. Yeah. It's like, you got the smell of weed and you got the psychedelic art, and it's perfect. Uh-huh. Anyway, sorry.
Poor Greg.
Can we get another tune from you, sir?
Well, now I got to think of something trippy.
All right.
Apparently. This is actually quite a new song, so I'm going to give that a whirl. Too new to be on the record. So I have a full-length record coming out May 15th.
Okay.
And this song is not on it. Promoting that viciously.
So right you're cranking out songs, dude.
Well, trying to.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
So it's called Nature's Twisting Heart. So.
A flutter in the eye, a transformation. Obscured by sunset through the trees, searching for the light you know is there, but can't quite make it out. The tears spill down in unison, steeping in the glory and the sadness of nature's twisting heart. Nature's twisting heart. A mood so strong that you want to hold on to it. Use it to create play. get it while you can. It will not stay. The tears spill down in unison, steeping in the glory and the sadness of nature's twisting heart. Nature's twisting heart. When the moon comes up, you can't say we're in true darkness. For dark as it may seem, it will shine in spite of us. The tears spill down in unison, steeping in the glory and the sadness of nature's twisting heart. Nature's twisting heart. Nature's twisting heart. Nature's twisting heart.
Yeah. That was beautiful. We're hanging with Greg Loiacono. I have a question for you. What do you listen to? Well, Is it hard to listen to other people's music when you're currently like in writing mode? And B, what do you listen to?
All
that's
right.
Not yours.
Okay, A.
PowerPoint.
Yeah.
Sorry.
No, I love listening to other people's music. And of course, I listen obnoxiously to my own music when I'm recording. It drives people in my house crazy. because I'm trying to...
Carolina.
I have to figure it out. And, you know, from writing, having a voice memo out on my phone and playing this song over and over again till when I record it 2 years from now, she's going to be like, the one I just played. You know, and all the other ones.
You hear that one a lot. That's
but
awesome.
So there's that. And then there's listening to people's music that I like, that are friends' music. People that I'm producing an album right now for a gentleman named Reed Jenauer.
Oh, he was on our show.
Oh, he was he? Yeah.
Fantastic
songwriter, and plays in a band called Assembly of Dust Strange Folk.
I remember him mostly because he was another name that I couldn't say.
Yeah, yeah. I practiced before I went into the studio. I sat in front of the mirror and I got it. You got to practice, man.
Exactly.
And so I've been listening to his music.
I feel
music.
Like he was telling me that.
Yeah. I've been listening to his music a lot.
Yeah, he's really good.
And then, you know, with the invention of things like Spotify, you can just listen to so much music all the time. And I have mixed feelings about that.
Yeah.
Right.
I went over to my friend Dave Schwartz the other night, and he's somewhere in here, and I played a Donald Byrd record for me and Ethiopian Nights. And he, you know, he had the actual record, but I found it on Spotify, and I've been listening to that all week. Yeah, there's a lot of music.
There's a lot.
Here's a question that I've been contemplating recently. Does anyone ever get... I feel really... Because music has been my whole life. I've basically made a career out of music, or talking about music, or interviewing musicians, or whatever. And I got to the point where I don't know if it was overload, but I wonder if I was going, am I depressed or something? I don't want to... listen to music for a while.
You just need a break sometimes.
No, but is that weird? Does anyone else? Does that ever happen?
It's not weird at all. And having it has been our career for so long. You know, where I work, everybody
Renee
fights.
Works for Metallica, by the way.
I work for Metallica. And everybody, when we get into the office, like it's kind of like the first one to get their computer on, they dictate what we're going
to
be hearing.
Yeah.
And it's just because it's at their desk and they play it loud enough or whatever. And I have never participated. I am 100% like, you play for me. Yeah. I can't wait to see what's coming at me today. And it's super fun. It's great. I never know what
but
we're going to listen to.
But nobody is like kissing up to the, it's not like Metallica all the time.
No, it's super fun. It's Techno Tuesday.
Okay.
And then it's, Mondays are tough because it's Metal Monday. Yeah. And it's like, it's really hard to concentrate when it's like, and you're like, oh my God.
Yeah, no,
it's Monday.
I would actually work from home that day. That would be Can we work from home?
Yeah, it's fun.
Do you know what it is with me? I think I love.
We're like Greg's therapy session.
I'm sorry. I love listening to new music. I feel like there's just so much. And you do the Spotify playlists, like the indie playlist or the alternative playlist or the this, that, the other. You know, I like a lot of alt country and Americana. And these playlists, and they're giving you 100 songs by 100 artists every week. And it's like, where the fuck do I be? Exactly. That's it.
And that was the beauty of...
And then you hear a tune, and then you're like, that you really like, and then you're like, okay, I'm going to listen to that album. And in but so many people are just making songs now and not records. And
Yeah. I was talking to my friend Scott, who I made the record with, and he's part of a band and recorded this band called His Golden Messenger. And they used
them.
To be in a band called The Court and Spark. And they used to open for the Mother Hips
no
all the time.
Way, yeah, that's them.
Yeah. And so
he was a big hit at, or they were a big hit at Outside Lands.
Yeah, for sure.
Last year.
Mind
Mike's
blown.
Great and Scott's great. And one of them rode in the Hips van when they were on tour with us, and they reported back, you know, to their crew, and like, what was it like? And like, it was really weird. And Scott was just telling me this story. I was like, oh God, what did we do in the van? You know? And he was like, Mike was just blown away because you guys drove for 3 hours and there wasn't a lick of music. Nobody listened to any music.
Oh.
And we didn't. We still don't if we're in the same vehicle. We rarely listen to music. And what happened is our van, affectionately known as Jockey, way back then, the tape player broke. Oh. And we love Merle Haggard.
Yeah.
And greatest hits of Merle Haggard got stuck. And that was all we listened to for about a year and a half.
Right,
straight.
That's, I remember
that's
that.
Why.
That is so funny.
And finally we were like, that's it. And we just stopped listening
it's
to
music. It's funny how that happens. I remember two vacations when I was a kid. One was in Europe somewhere. And the only tape we had was Buddy Holly's Greatest Hits. But I swear to God, I could still listen to Buddy Holly's Greatest Hits. And
I
never
listen
get
to
tired.
Hag every day. So.
And then another vacation where it was just the only record we had on a little Dansette record player, which is aging me, but was London Calling. And you just listened to it over and over again. But I will say this. I'm talking about, you know, I'm not listening. There's a few records that I've really gotten into in the last few weeks. So I feel like I'm coming back. The new Tame Impala record. But I really was getting worried. I'm like, have I lost the gene in my head that kind of the receptor?
You're all right.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're fine. Totally.
The therapy session is over. I'm like, what's her name? Who is the girl in Snoopy, the 5 cents psychiatrist? Lucy, thank you. You've all been my Lucy. I appreciate it. 5 cents. There you go.
$5 now.
$5. Inflation. Okay, we're going to get a couple more tunes from Greg. I know he's going to do an original, and then we'll probably get a cover version to finish everything out.
Yeah, no, I just want to check. Do you have this? Because I think the battery in this floor tuner might have died. Do you have the guitar? Okay. So, I'll do another one that I've rarely done. Why not?
Why
it's
not?
Called Do What You Do.
All right.
Yeah.
It was dark when you did what you did. You tell me over and over you wanna keep it here, but you know there were birds listening at dawn, and they flew off to go sing it to me. and kerosene. Now I would not have wanted to be in those shoes, but surely you know that it's no kind of excuse. So do what you do, but don't tell me. Do what you do, but don't tell me. Do what you do, but don't tell me. 'Cause I don't wanna know. The houses you robbed, the hearts you stole, the dirty deals you made don't matter to me. But could you please keep them to yourself?
Back into music.
Okay, you're back now.
No, I'm back. You know what? That was really good. And I hate comparing stuff to other people, but it was like I wanted to do hand claps throughout.
I saw you over there.
Yeah. I'm gonna do that. But like a George Harrison tune or even the Everly Brothers. It's just like this.
Definitely inspired by both.
Yeah, it was wonderful. Yeah. Thank you.
And for me, it was my entire relationship with my parents. They were like, do what you do. Don't tell me.
You see the,
that's right.
And she's don't get arrested.
Right. She's the lyrics. I'm the melody.
Yeah.
Right? Renee and I are like a tune. She's the lyrics. I'm the melody.
I love that.
That was really, really good. So we, Greg and I were talking before the show about, you know, the covers and stuff that you do with the Greenleaf Rustlers and Burrito Brothers and Graham Parsons and the Birds. And that's all my wheelhouse. And that's maybe why I don't like music anymore, because none of them are around. But he graciously, Greg, agreed to do a song that he sometimes... So Chris Robinson doesn't hog the spotlight in the Greenleaf.
Not at all.
He allows everybody to contribute.
He puts me on the spot.
And you get to play it already?
Yeah.
It's like play a couple of tunes?
It's great. Yeah,
that's good.
I get to. So this is one that I'll sometimes do in that band. It's called Train Leaves Here This Morning by Dillard and Clark. Okay. And the Eagles did it. So some people... That's an Eagles song, but it's actually Gene Clark wrote it.
It's on a
record called The Fantastic Expeditions of Dillard and Clark.
Oh, wow.
And they're on the cover in a motorcycle with a sidecar.
Oh, yeah.
And in leather.
Yeah.
And with the little leather hats, and they're passing some sort of cigarette.
Yeah. I have to ask, because I always think of, when I think of the Greenleaf Rustlers, I always think of Pappy and Harriet, sorry, in Pioneertown.
Pappy and Harriet.
Yes. And I always want to go. It just seems so.
It seems like
that's down near Joshua Tree or Palms in Palm Desert, right?
Yeah.
Right near 29 Palms, and it's that old. It was the old movie sets where they used to make westerns back in the day. And there's this cool bar there. And whenever I'm there, there's never any music. But it just seems like the greatest place to either see a show or play a show.
It's really fun, and the barbecue's great, and the feeling is really fun out there in the desert.
Pappy and Harriet. Never get it right. See, I only just got Loiacono right, and now I'll be 20 years getting the name of a bar right.
It all takes time, man.
Yeah, thank you.
So we'll see. We'll see if I can get this one right. But
it sounded
great. You put me on the spot here, but I really like this song. This is one of the first Gene Clark songs I ever heard, and Tim and I fell in love with it right away, and I was able to eventually start playing it with those guys. So.
Okay. Cool.
I lost 10 points just for being in the right place at exactly the wrong time. Looked around then for some facts, but I may as well have been completely blind. And if you see me walking all alone, don't look back, I'm just on my way back home. There's a train leaves here this morning, I don't know what I might be on. Wanted me to sign a contract, baby said it would all be so lifelong. I looked around then for a reason when there wasn't something more to blame it on. And if time makes a difference while we're gone, tell me now and I won't be hanging on. There's a train morning, I don't know what I might be on. $13.20 North Columbus was the address I had written on my sleeve. Didn't know just where she was going, but I knew that it was getting time to leave. And I watched as the smoker passed it on, and I laughed when the joker said, lead on. There's a train leaves here this morning, I don't know what I might be on. There's a train leaves here this morning, I don't know what I might be on.
Loiacono. I'm Renee and Irish Greg's pop-up show.
Thank you, Greg, so very, very much.
Thank you.
Big
so
round
much.
Of applause. Thanks, guys. Look at that.
Yeah.
Okay, so normally we don't warn our guests about this, but I actually remembered to tonight that when we read the credits we're about to do, because we have a lot of people to thank and a lot of sponsors, if the musician doesn't stay and play the credits music, then you guys all leave. So, we've asked Greg to play some credits music, and we are going to... Don't act like it's a surprise, I told you.
Greg, get into the drama.
Greg's going to play some music, and we're going to read some credits, because it takes a lot of people to put this show together. And one thing... So, the Haight Street Arts Center generously allows us to use this space. However, electricity and staff and bathrooms and everything that goes into putting this place together is not free. So we are going to pass around a hat, and if everybody wouldn't mind.
It's not a hat, it's a bucket.
It's a bucket. If everybody wouldn't mind just contributing a few bucks, it helps us kind of feel like we're paying our way here at the Haight Street Arts Center. Renee, do you want to start or should
sure,
I start?
Sure, I'll start. All right, this podcast and video will be available Monday at popupbayarea.org. on our Patreon page, which is patreon.com/popupbayarea, or just search for Renee and Irish Greg's Pop-Up on Apple Podcasts, Stitcher, and Google Play.
On Patreon, you can support us to help keep these shows going. Become a patron at the $5 a month level, gets you into these events, plus complimentary free drinks from 21st Amendment Brewery and Whetstone Wine Cellars. Woo!
Woo! And we are adding tons, well, Greg is adding tons of old KFOG Morning Show interviews and 10 at 10s, live performances, and a bunch of videos. So your financial support is greatly appreciated and helps subsidize that production.
Exactly. Follow us on social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, at Pop-Up Bay Area. Please remember that likes are nice, but retweets and shares help us grow as well as help the artists grow. I noticed a lot of you videotaping and photographing tonight, and that's absolutely cool. But if you would tag us and tag Greg, that really, really does help a lot. Thank you.
And much appreciation to our host, as always, the non-for-profit Haight Street Art Center. Tell your friends, come visit. It's a free resource, and they have the incredible Stanley Mouse show that is going on right now, haightstreetart.org.
Thanks to my beautiful, lovely wife, Samantha Martin, for the bar.
Her new boyfriend, Dylan Chambers.
Dylan Chambers, exactly. She's going to, I think she and Dylan are in the bathroom right now. Robert Arroyo, who greeted you on the door. Thank you, Robert. Always helps out so much. And of course, PK. Thank you, PK, for helping out as well.
And of course, Ben Bernstein. He does our sound.
Thank you, Ben.
BenBernsteinMusic.com.
Thanks to our wonderful sponsors, 21st Amendment Brewery. Visit their pub on 2nd Street in San Francisco and their tap room in San Leandro. Also, the amazing Whetstone Wine Cellars, Michelle Whetstone.
Michelle is here.
Was helping out behind the bar tonight. A must visit. Their chateau in Napa is incredible. It's only about a mile from downtown Napa, and it feels like you're in the middle of the French countryside. Visit it. WhetstoneWineCellars.com.
And of course, the amazing, the wonderful, the one and only Greg Loiacono.
Thank you.
Check out his solo project. Check out his work with the Mother Hips, of course, and the Green Leaf Rustlers as well. And his new single, Animal Clouds, is available in all the usual digital formats. And the CD will be coming out.
And vinyl will be coming out May 15th.
Okay, we've just got another couple of little things and then we're done, okay? He's like, I'm out of chords. Please join us for our next show. It is our, and it's always a bit raucous. Yeah. It's our fourth annual Paddy's Day special, right here at the Haight Street Art Center, March 14th, Owen Harrington, and I don't know if he's going to bring his Irish rap band this time, but if any of you were here 2 years ago, it was hilarious. So Owen Harrington and Sin Silver play here Saturday, March 14th, and like a lot of our shows, it is free, but you're a guaranteed entry if you're a patron.
And make sure you mark your calendar for this one, Tuesday, April 21st, right here at the Haight Street Art Center. We are going to have Madeline Peru.
Exactly. And for that one, you actually do have to be a patron. So Madeline Peru is on Tuesday, the 21st of April. Finally, thanks to you, all of you, for coming. Patrons or not, please consider supporting us on Patreon. But thanks for coming regardless. Thank you
very,
very much.
Everybody.
Thank you, Greg.
Thank you.
That was a lot of fun. Thanks.